everything you need to know about Universal Orlando park tickets and why you should find out about this early in your planning. This is Go Inform Podcast, episode 65. Hey, everybody, welcome to the show. Thanks for joining me today. My name's Maven. I am the hostess here at Go Informed. And today we are going to talk about Universal Orlando park tickets. Park tickets are one of those things that I think a lot of people kind of imagine being one of the last things to decide about or purchase when it comes to planning a vacation. And I am here today to tell you that I think it's a really smart idea to take a look at the park ticket options early on in your planning. So today we are going to take a deeper dive into looking at how Universal Orlando structures their park ticket pricing and why you should look at this soon so you can get a sense of what is going to be the best deal for you, which park tickets you choose are going to drive actually quite a few decisions. So obviously it's going to drive how many days you're going to spend in the parks at Universal. That can help you decide how long you want to stay, where you want to stay, even which hotel you choose. So it makes it really important to have a sense of how these tickets are structured and how you can save some money, how you might want to add another day on or take one off. And so looking at this early on will really make a difference in your planning and just efficiency of your trip. So there are show notes for today's episode, of course. Those are at goinform.net/65. I definitely recommend that you take a look at that. Buying tickets at Universal Orlando, actually, there are a lot of different kind of permutations of how the tickets can be structured. And when you go to purchase these tickets, it can be really confusing. So on the website, on the show notes, I've got just kind of step-by-step directions and all of the things I'm going to talk about today written down so you don't have to take notes. You can just refer to that. So again, those are at goinform.net/65. So one thing, though, that you might want to take a look at, even while you're listening to me, is head over to Universal's website and pull up their ticket purchasing page. You just go over to universalorlando.com and you'll see a button somewhere that says buy tickets, park tickets, something like that. So if you take a look at that, that's going to take you into the page where you can purchase tickets. And, you know, you can look at that as and stick stuff in your cart and all you want to your heart's content without actually buying any tickets. And this is a super powerful tool for a lot of reasons that we're going to get into. But I really suggest that you don't wait until the day you're going to buy your tickets to first look at that site. There are just a lot of things you need to decide, and it's really nice to kind of know where you want to go with it before you get on the site and ready with your credit card. So we're going to go through all of the different questions that you're going to get asked and the different decisions you're going to need to make to buy those tickets. And this can help you, again, this can help you decide, you know, how you want to structure your park days and your time at Universal. So there are a number of things that you're going to have to decide when you buy those tickets. And these are things that you should be deciding as you're planning your trip too. There's really five, maybe six questions that you need to ask yourself. The first one is, how many days admission are you going to need in the parks? Secondly, how many of the parks do you want to see? And then How many of those parks do you want to be able to see on the same day? Do you want to just do one park per day? Or do you want to be able to switch between two or even all three of the parks? Then you're going to need to know what the first date is going to be that you'll be in the Universal Orlando parks. The pricing on the tickets actually is date-based, so it is important to know when you're going to go, not just what week it is or what month it is, but literally the first day that you're going to be in the parks. Other options that you have related to admission at Universal is you can add Express Pass onto your tickets. This is an extra kind of golden ticket purchase that you can put on top of your park tickets. And for some people, an annual pass may actually make more sense. So let's talk about all of these different things and kind of take them one at a time. So the first option you're going to have is to figure out how many days you want to spend in the Universal Orlando parks. And, you know, right now you may have that exactly figured out. You know, you may be like, I've got one day and then that's it. But a lot of times looking at the ticket pricing can really help drive this decision. Universal is really good about discounting their park tickets and offering promotional ticket options that often add extra days onto the ticket for free. So this is one of these reasons why you want to get on that website and take a look at how much these tickets really cost. Because one of the things you're going to find is that on a per day basis, the most expensive park tickets are going to be the 1 day tickets. 1 day tickets are almost always not discounted, unless you might be a Florida resident. In that case, maybe you'll find a deal. But for most of us, we're not going to find a discount on a 1 day park ticket. So those are always the most pricey in terms of per day. When you start adding, going from one, even just 1 to 2 days, the incremental additional cost is not double. And then when you start going, you know, into 3 or 4 there, you can actually go anywhere from a 1 to 5 day park ticket at Universal. As you start adding those days, your cost does not go up by as much as you might expect. So just to give you guys some numbers, I just looked at pricing for a 1 day, one park ticket for March 17th of 2021. And the price for that day is $140. If you buy a 2 day, same park ticket for 2 days, starting on that same date, that goes up to $249. So your increase, it doesn't go to $280. It doesn't double. It goes up to $249. If you buy the 3 day option for the same park ticket, it's $270. So you can kind of see there how as you're adding those extra days on, your cost is not going to go up like by a full multiple. In fact, it really starts to drop quite a bit as you get, especially once you get up into like a 3 day ticket. So if you're on the fence about how many days to spend in these parks, you know, adding that extra day, you know, like that third day, if that's, let's say you're going to stay on site and you're staying for 2 nights and one of the days is kind of a partial day because you're going to be flying out late that day, you know, you may still want to get a ticket for that day, you know, just buy a 3 day ticket because it's only like $30 more to get that third day. And even if you only spend half a day in the park, you know, you've only paid an extra $30 to get that. So keep this in mind when you're trying to figure out your touring and how many days you want to spend, because sometimes it's just not that much more to add those extra days on. But here is another really big tip about buying your tickets for Universal. Because of the way they structure their promotional tickets, you can often get a ticket, a multi-day ticket, for a lot less money than the regular ticket pricing. And Universal almost always has some kind of special promotional ticket. Right now, they are offering a four-day park ticket for less than the price of a standard two-day ticket. So it's basically like buy 2 days and get two free. For that same date that I just told you that 3 days would cost you $270, if you get their promotional ticket that they are selling right now, it's only $225 and it gives you 4 days park admission. So there you can see like how powerful these promotional tickets can be. This is a promotion that Universal is selling these tickets on their website. Just you will see it. When you go on that page where you buy your tickets, you will see those promotional tickets advertised right up front. That's the one they want you to buy. They want you to come to their parks for 4 days instead of 2 days. They want you to consider staying on site because why wouldn't you if you're going to go to the park so many times? Those promotional options are not hidden. You're going to see them right up front. I know a lot of you guys, this promotion might be gone by the time you listen to me, but for those of you who are listening in spring 2021, that promotion is running. You have to buy the tickets by April 27th, and you just have to use them by December 17th, 2021. So this is their current promotion on their tickets. I'm positive that during 2021, you're going to see promotional tickets offered all year long. This may not be the promotion that they do the whole time. So I have seen them do things where it's like pay for a one park ticket and get an extra park for free. Sometimes they'll throw, you know, Volcano Bay in there for free. Sometimes they'll add a free express pass. So there's a lot of different things that they will do to try to entice you to buy those longer term or bigger tickets. And the price can be a really, really good deal. So make sure you're checking this out. You can see that this can make the difference between whether you just buy a one-day ticket and just try to do it all in one day, or you get this kind of ticket, and even if you didn't go for 4 days, you're paying like less than the two-day price for that ticket. So you could go for 2 days, 3 days, whatever, at a really good price. And if you're going to do that, then you may want to consider staying on site. And I'm sure that is why they offer this kind of a promotion. Another thing to know about the number of days that your ticket's going to cover, you don't have to enter the parks on that number of days consecutively. So if you have, say you have a 3 day park ticket, you just have to use it within 6 days of the start date on the ticket. So they don't make you just like do boom, boom, boom all in a row. They let you have some time to use the tickets. And depending on how many days tickets you get, it's going to affect how long you have to use them. But even a 2 day park ticket, you don't have to go back to back. You just have 5 days to use it. So keep that in mind too when you're planning your touring and trying to decide how feasible a multi-day ticket will be for you. Keep in mind that you don't have to do it all right back to back. All right, so now the next thing that you're going to need to figure out is how many parks you want to visit. So there are three theme parks on Universal Orlando's tickets. The parks are Islands of Adventure, Universal Studios Florida, and Volcano Bay. Volcano Bay is the water park. It's highly themed. It has a lot of cool stuff. It's a fairly new park. And if you like water parks, then you will probably want to see Volcano Bay. The other two parks are the traditional theme parks. They are right next to each other. You can walk between them in like 10 minutes or even less. And there's a lot to see in each of those parks. When you choose your ticket, you're going to need to determine how many parks you want to see. So if Volcano Bay is important to you, then you're going to want to buy a three-park ticket. A two-park ticket always just includes Universal Studios Florida and Islands of Adventure. A one-park ticket will let you get into either of those parks, just one of them. You can also buy a one park ticket that's just for Volcano Bay. It costs a little bit less than the one park ticket that's good for Islands of Adventure or Universal Studios Florida. I told you guys this is confusing and complicated. So you need to know which parks you want to spend time in. Make sure that you're doing some homework with this. You know, you can listen to my park tours, which are early, way, way back episodes like 3, 4, and 5 of the show. You can also, I really recommend getting a hold of an unofficial guide to Universal Orlando because they have everything you need to know about what's in the parks. And, you know, I'm sure you guys are doing other research, looking at videos on YouTube, all that stuff. But it's good to know ahead of time to have at least an idea of what it is you want to see at Universal because it's split up into these two theme parks. And most importantly, the Wizarding World of Harry Potter is in two theme parks. So you have Diagon Alley over at Universal Studios Florida, and you have Hogsmeade Village over in Islands of Adventure. So if you want to see all of the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, you're going to need a ticket that will get you into both Islands of Adventure and Universal Studios Florida. Now you have some choices here, depending on how many days you want to visit. If you're only visiting for one day, then you kind of don't have a choice. If you want to see both parks, you're going to have to buy a two-park ticket that is a park-to-park ticket that allows you to go into both parks on that day. That is what Universal calls their ticket option that lets you go between the parks. It's called a park-to-park ticket. This is an add-on to your basic ticket. Now, if you're going for 2 days and you want to see both of those two parks, you can actually buy a 2-day, 2-park, 1-park-per-day ticket. Okay? So 1 park per day means what it sounds like. You can only go into 1 park for any given day. Whichever one you go in the morning, that's the only one you can go in all day long. You cannot, you know, switch and go over to the other one. This saves you some money. It does cost extra to add the park-to-park option onto your ticket. But, you know, it confines you just to that one park. And so if the weather shuts down an attraction that you really wanted to see, or it's really crowded in that park, and the one next door isn't so crowded, you don't have the option to switch. You are just going to be in the one, and then, you know, the second day, you can go to the other one and just be in that one. Or you can add the park-to-park option onto your tickets. This is another one of those things where, especially if you're going for 2 or 3 or more days, it's not incrementally that much to add park-to-park. It costs, I looked at, again, these same tickets that I was telling you guys about earlier going in March. Adding park to park to a 2-park ticket is about $60. It's $60 flat, not per day. So if you have a 1-day park to park ticket, it's going to cost about $60 more for that day to be able to go between the parks. If you have a 2-day park-to-park ticket, it costs you $60 more. So like $30 more per day. And, you know, you can see, like 3 days, you're only paying $20 more a day for the option. So again, they want you to go for multiple days, so they are not dinging you for that. They want to make it easier for you to go for multiple days. The park-to-park ticket is especially valuable if you're a Harry Potter fan because there's a ride in the Wizarding World of Harry Potter that you can only do if you have a park-to-park ticket, and that's the Hogwarts Express. The Hogwarts Express goes between Diagon Alley and Hogsmeade Village both ways, and it is really cool. And it's a really cool way also to get between the parks. But the thing about it is that because it goes between the parks, you need a park-to-park ticket in order to ride that train. You cannot go into the other park if you only have a one park per day ticket. And they, when they scan you through to get on the train, they check your park admission to make sure that you have valid admission for that second park on that day. So it's almost like you just have to get park to park if you're really driven by going to see the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. It's really cool, actually, that you're able to do the train to go between these two parts of the Wizarding World. It keeps you so immersed into it, and it's a different ride each direction. I mean, how can you be going into Hogsmeade Village, literally getting off the Hogwarts Express and being there? It's very cool. So keep this in mind. This is really, really important because you're going to be sad if you don't have the right park ticket. I mean, they will sell you an upgrade to so that you can ride on the train, but that also doesn't always make sense because, you know, you would have wanted, if you wanted this promotional ticket and you wanted to add park to park on, like, you want to get that early and have it locked in. So keep this in mind and be aware of it. Now, you can also get a three-park park-to-park ticket, which would allow you to go to Volcano Bay for part of your day. And Volcano Bay, with touring over there, the best things to do are to go like really early in the morning. Use the, if you're staying on site, use early admission because it's really popular. Or to go at the end of the day when most people, especially the locals, have already left. So having Volcano Bay as an option in your park-to-park ticket, if this is something you want to see, it's really nice because you don't have to go and spend the whole day there. You could just kind of do it, you know, after you've done the Wizarding World for most of the day, then go hang out at the beach at Volcano Bay at the end of the day. So that is also an option that you have. Okay, so let's see. We've done how many days do you want to go? How many parks? How many parks per day? So another question you need to answer is what will be the first day that you're going to be inside the parks? The pricing of the tickets is based on the date. And here's another way that you can learn a lot about how to plan your trip just by looking at the ticket prices for the parks. And the reason is that this date-based pricing is based on their prediction of the crowds. So if you're going to visit on a really busy day, like, you know, the most busy day of the year, I think, is Christmas or New Year's, that is going to be the highest price ticket that you're going to find. If you're going on a really low crowd time, then that's going to be the lowest price tickets. And just to give you guys kind of an idea of how the pricing swings, if you're just buying a one day, one park ticket right now, the lowest price ticket is $109 for the day, and the highest price is $139. It's a pretty big swing, depending on when you travel. So if you get on the site, what you're going to want to do is take a look, you know, assuming that you don't know the exact date you're going to go to Universal, you may have a week in mind, you may have a couple weeks in mind, depending on your flexibility. But look at that calendar. You can actually, when you get in there to choose your date, it will pop up a whole month, maybe even 2 months worth of days, and you can see the price for every single day on that calendar. So sometimes what you'll notice is that if you've got a week that you're going to be in Orlando, that there's a couple days during that week that the price on the tickets is lower than other days. So maybe that will drive which days you want to spend at Universal. Remember, because the pricing is based on crowd projections, the days with the lower price also means there will probably be fewer people in the parks. So this is actually a really good crowd calendar to, you know, this is Universal's estimates of what their crowds are going to be. And if you see low pricing on the time that you're going to visit, that's a good sign that your crowds probably will be lower. If you see the high prices, you need to be aware that that will be a busier time of the year, and you're going to need to have, you know, some real strategies for how to deal with those crowds. But either way, it's really great to have that heads up instead of planning everything, making your hotel reservations based on a certain day of the week you were going to go to Universal, and then you realize, oh, that's the one day that's the most busy. So take a look at this stuff early, because this is really important information. Universal does offer one type of a ticket that isn't date-based. They call it a flex ticket, and it has, the only restriction is you have to use it within a year of purchase. But the flex ticket is priced the same as the highest price ticket of any day of the year. And you don't really need to buy your ticket that far in advance. If you really don't know what day you're going to use it, just wait until you do, because you'll probably save some money, and there's really no reason to just spend this money on a ticket that you're not sure what day you're going to use it. So figure out what day you want before you actually buy your tickets. So at this point, you would have clicked all the buttons to purchase your ticket and get it in your cart. So, you know, you will have decided number of days, number of parks per day, and what day your ticket's going to start. And you can click that all in there, and it will put it in your cart. And the next thing Universal is going to ask you is if you want to add Express Pass. Now, Express Pass is something that has its own, it is its own topic. I did a whole episode about Express Pass back on episode 33, and I really recommend that you listen to that if you're visiting Universal. Whether you're getting an Express Pass or not, it will impact how you tour and how you see other people touring in the parks, and it's a really good idea to know what Express Pass is and kind of understand the nuances of when you might want to have an Express Pass and all of that. So after you're done listening to this episode, if you have not listened to that one, scroll back and learn more about Express Pass, because I'm going to give you like the 60-second quick thing right now about it. So basically what Express Pass is it's kind of like your golden ticket. At Universal, almost all of the attractions have their regular entrance to the ride. It's called the standby queue. And then most of them also have the Express Pass queue. The Express Pass queue bypasses that regular line. It's a much faster way to get onto the attractions. Typically with Express Pass, you're almost going to just walk on, even at a busy time where the attraction's standby wait might be an hour or more. If you have Express Pass, you should be on the ride within 15 minutes. So Express Pass is like, it's the express lane. It gets you on the ride fast. You can see a lot more of the park when you have Express Pass, and it's just super convenient, and you don't have all the stress of standing around in line and watching the Express Pass people just breezing past. So Express Pass might, if you're familiar with Disneyland or Disney World's Fast Pass system, this is going to sound kind of familiar, because it's a similar idea, but there are some differences. The first thing is that Express Pass is not time-based. So you can go in, if you have Express Pass, you can use that entrance whenever you feel like it. It's not like you have a certain time to come back and ride through the Express Pass lane. You can just go whenever you want. The other thing about Express Pass is that it costs money. It's an extra add-on to your ticket, and it is not cheap. even though it costs money, it can really be worth it, especially if you're traveling during a busy time of the year because of how much time it's going to save you. Or if you're only going for one day, having an express pass will let you see so much more than if you don't. So there are some real benefits to having express pass. There's two options, of course, just like everything else with Universal, there's all these options. So with Express Pass, they have two types. They have standard and they have unlimited. So standard Express Pass is going to allow you to skip the line once per day for any given attraction. So, you know, you get your one time, skip the line, and then you're going to be in the standby line for that attraction the rest of the day. If you have an unlimited express pass, there is no limit. You can go on the same ride through express pass 50 times if you want. So unlimited really gives you a ton of freedom for just kind of feeling like you own the place. Now the cost for standard versus unlimited, it's a pretty big difference. Standard express pass is going to start a pricing at about $60 per day. But the pricing, when you start adding unlimited, and this is also date-based, so it costs a lot more if you're visiting on a busy day, you can pay up to $260 per day for an unlimited express pass. So you guys, I mean, this can add a lot of cost to your park ticket. And before you drive your car off the road or have a heart attack for all of this, calm down, because there is a way to get your express pass without ponying up all this money. And again, I do dive into this quite a bit on that episode 33. So if this is starting to sound appealing to you, what I'm about to say, make sure you listen to that. If you stay on site in one of three of the Universal Orlando hotels, either the Hard Rock Hotel, the Portofino Bay Hotel, or the Royal Pacific Hotel, any of these hotels, all of the guests that stay in them receive free unlimited express pass for the entire length of their stay. So even if you only stay in one of those hotels for one night, you will receive unlimited express pass for 2 days, the day you check in and the day you check out. And it's just part of the deal if you stay in one of those hotels. And almost always, it is cheaper to stay in the hotel and get the express pass included, especially if you have more than two people in your room, than it is just to buy the express passes. And, you know, a lot of times it's almost like you're getting a free room because of the cost of those express passes, the value of getting them for free. So if express is important to you, it's really a good idea to take a look at these hotels and consider adding one or two nights on site in an express pass hotel during your trip. Then you don't have to add it onto your park ticket. It's your room key, you guys. That's your express pass. So it's really easy. It's a great benefit. These three hotels are the premier hotels on site. You can walk to the parks from them. They have a ton of other, you know, really great amenities and benefits. And you get the unlimited express pass. So be sure to check out my show notes where you'll find out more about that. That's, again, goinform.net/65. If you want to dive straight to the express pass show notes, it's just /33 for that one, because episode 33. But really, this is one of my top tips. If you go on to my 33 things to know about Universal Orlando, I'm pretty sure this is tip number one: stay in one of those hotels. So when you're buying your park tickets, you don't have to buy the express pass with the tickets. You can actually add express anytime. You can buy the Express Pass, you know, before your trip as you get closer. You can add Express Pass at the gate or even once you're in the park. And you might get in, you might be like, I am not spending that money. And then you get in the park and it's so crowded. And you can literally go to a store inside the park and get Express Pass. There is one caveat to that. They will sell out of Express Pass if it's super busy. So it depends on when you're traveling. But for the most part, you don't have to make that decision yet. So if you want to just get that promotional park ticket, you know, buy it, lock it in, and then decide about Express later, explore the hotels, whatever, you know, you have that option. Now, there is one other thing that I want you to consider when you're thinking about your park tickets, and it's sort of outside of the box here, and that is an annual pass. Now, I know you might live in London and wonder why you should get an annual pass for Universal Orlando when you're only going to go there for one trip, you know, this year, and you don't know when you're coming back. And the reason for this is the benefits that are attached to an annual pass. And one thing to note, too, is that Universal's annual pass prices are not as high as you might think. For an out-of-state guest, an annual pass is going to be priced around the same price as a four-day park ticket. So it's not that big of a stretch. And if you're planning to go for multiple days, it could actually be almost a wash on the cost. But the main thing about a Universal Orlando annual pass when it comes to out-of-state visitors is the hotel discounts. So Universal discounts their on-site hotels for annual pass holders up to around 30% off the regular price. And this can be a really big savings. And there's often annual pass holder discounts where there's not another type of discount, especially when you get into those Express Pass level hotels. So annual pass holders can really save a lot of money on the stay. And here's the thing, you guys, if you want to use an annual pass holder discount on a hotel room, only one person in that room needs to have an annual pass. So, you know, if you've got four people, you don't have to buy four annual passes. You just need to get one. And then that person is eligible for the room discount. And, you know, that's how you get it. Now, there's a lot of different levels of annual passes, and each of them have, you know, different perks, but all of them have the hotel discount. And this is another thing where I did a whole episode, and there's a big blog post about it. That was episode 40. And so show notes about the annual passes is goinform.net/40. And I do have a quick rundown of this on today's episode show notes too. So if you go there, you'll be able to get into all the details. But the main thing to know is that having an annual pass can really save money on your hotel. And the cool thing at Universal is that you can make your booking, even if you don't have an annual pass yet. You can book at the annual pass discount. You just need to have the pass by the time you show up to check in. And that means you can check the annual pass holder rates on the hotels, even if it's not like you need some secret login or anything like that. You just need to know where to look. So over in the show notes for today's show and the annual pass show, you'll see a link to where you can check out the discounted rates on the Universal Orlando website. So you can go over there and you can see, are they discounting the room that I was going to get anyway? And how much is it? And you can do the math and decide, like, are you going to save more money by buying an annual pass than it actually costs to get the pass? So you have all this information you can get up front. Now, the hotel discounts, for these kind of discounts, they don't usually show up until about 6 weeks or 2 months before your trip. So you may not be able to make this decision right away. You might have to wait to see if it makes sense to get the annual pass. So keep that in mind. I mean, this current promotional price on the park tickets is so great that, you know, you may just want to do that and then just pay whatever it is for the hotel without the annual pass discount. But if you're in a position where you kind of just in a wait and see mode or whatever, you may want to like just keep an eye on those pass holder discounts in the hotels. And if it makes sense, get yourself an annual pass. When you buy an annual pass, it doesn't actually start, the year doesn't actually start ticking until the moment you first enter a park with that pass. So if you buy the annual pass 2 months before your vacation, that's okay. It doesn't mean the year starts ticking on the day you buy it. It will just start ticking on the day you first go into the parks. The other thing to know, you guys, is that right now, and I have seen this before, Universal Orlando is giving a 15-month pass for the price of a 12-month pass. So they're actually giving extra months on top of these annual passes. So if you think that you might actually have a return visit, maybe a little more than a year after your first trip to Universal, then you really might benefit from an annual pass because you won't have to buy park tickets if you come back in 13 months. You still have an annual pass. So do consider this. This is rather unique to Universal. Disney's annual passes are so much higher priced that it usually does not make sense to purchase one over there, but it really can at Universal. So keep this in your, you know, just kind of keep this in your back pocket as an option, another way to save some money. If you can get that discount at an Express Pass hotel, then you are really going to be doing it, you guys. You're going to save money on that hotel. You're going to get free Express Passes. You're going to be an annual pass holder with all the benefits that come with that. So do consider it. Again, episode 40, I talk a lot more about how this works and get into some numbers and all that stuff. So do check that out if this sounds intriguing. All right, just a few more little tips and tidbits of things to know. So when should you buy your park tickets? At Universal, there's not really any reason you have to buy your park tickets far in advance. Obviously, if there is a great deal going on, that would be a reason to do that and just to lock in that rate. But you don't have a situation at Universal where you need to own those tickets for some reason before you get into the park. Disney does have reservations and stuff that you need to have a park ticket in order to do those things. We're going to talk about Disney park tickets next time, so we'll get into that with them. But Universal doesn't do that. So in terms of when you need to actually buy these tickets, whenever you feel like it looks good, it's kind of the answer I would give you. I do recommend that you have your tickets before you actually go to the park on the first day. I mean, you don't want to stand in line to buy tickets when you could be, you know, first in line at the gate. Also, you can buy your tickets in a lot of ways at Universal, so it makes it really easy to have them already in hand. You can even buy these tickets on the Universal Orlando app. So make it easy for yourself. Get them ahead of time so you have them, but don't, you know, don't sweat if it's 3 weeks before your trip and you still don't have your park tickets. You know, buy them when you're ready. Do know, though, that the prices can increase at any time. So locking in a price is one reason to get them ahead of time. And make sure you have them before you get to the gate so you don't have the hassle of, you know, trying to buy them on that first day. Other ways that you can buy the tickets besides just getting them directly through Universal, you can buy your park tickets as part of a vacation package. So a vacation package will include your hotel and your park tickets and sometimes other stuff like rental car and stuff like that. You can book a vacation package directly with Universal or a travel agent can book you a universal vacation package, or, you know, Costco, Expedia, some of these third parties often offer packages. And the nice thing about buying your tickets in a package is that sometimes you can save some money on everything by bundling it together. If you buy a package that's booked through Universal, either directly, you know, on their site or by calling them, or your travel agent books it that way, they will be able to get you that promotional ticket. Whatever the promo is at the time, you can get it in your package too. If you book a package through like Costco or Expedia, they may have a different deal. But in any case, when you buy a package, a lot of times you can just put a deposit down at the time you make the reservation, and then you just need to make final payment, you know, usually like a month before you travel. And that allows you to, you know, not pay for everything right now up front. I mean, park tickets, if you're buying multi-day park tickets and you've got four people, that can be a pretty big outlay. So when you use a package, you can often just put a few $100s down at first. And then if you want to make payments before your trip, you can do that, or you can just wait and make final payment later. It can help, you know, spread out the costs financially. So that's another option. If you guys are looking for a travel agent, you know, send me a message. I can give you some referrals. But that can be a good way to you know, book your vacation. And the other thing is, if you want to buy the tickets through a third party at a discount, and there are places where you can get some, usually just a modest discount, but some discount on Universal Orlando Park tickets. This is like, you know, AAA or Costco sometimes, or some of these online ticket sellers will have park tickets at a discount. You're usually not going to find one-day park tickets discounted even through sellers like this. It's usually going to be the multi-day options. And make sure, if you're looking at something like that, do compare it to whatever you're seeing on Universal's website, because, again, these promotional offers can sometimes be better than what you're going to find through one of these other sources. So make sure you have an idea of what Universal is directly offering before you make your decision to purchase through someone else. And then, of course, you know, make sure you're buying through a reputable source, so you're not getting fake tickets. That would be super sad. You don't want to show up at the gate and find out you don't have real tickets. So just make sure you know, you're dealing with someone reputable. But those discounts do exist. So that is a ton of information about something that you would think would be a super simple component of your Orlando trip. This is why it suddenly struck me that we needed to talk about park tickets, because it can be so confusing. And as you can see, it's really smart to know about these prices, know how it's structured, know your options early on in your planning. You know, it's never too soon to find out what Universal's pricing these park tickets at and what kind of promotions they're offering. This can totally drive, you know, how many days you're going to spend there and where you're going to want to stay. If you hop back a couple episodes, about five episodes back, I did a whole show just about the Universal Orlando hotels. So if, you know, if you're listening to this and you're like, yeah, I think we are going to want to go to the parks more than one day, I really do encourage you to consider staying on site. For a myriad of reasons. And there are hotels ranging in prices, like all the way from really budget-friendly, brand new hotels on site at Universal, all the way to the luxury Express Pass hotels. So there is really something for everyone there. So make sure you take a look at that. And there's links to all of that in the show notes too. So you guys, the show notes again, goinform.net/65. Next time, we are going to talk about Disney World park tickets. So make sure you're hitting the subscribe button or whatever it is that will automatically give you the next episode of this show on your podcast player. And thanks for joining me, you guys. I hope we can get you to Orlando soon. And I hope you're having fun kind of dreaming about this. I know I am. So have a great day and thanks for listening.